Historians believe the tradition of a special ham dinner at the holidays actually began with the ancient Celtic tribes of Europe and came over with the early American pioneers. For centuries, the recipe for a country ham was pretty much the same. One Virginia tradition has it that Captain John Smith learned the trick of preserving ham from the Indians who lived on Hog Island near Jamestown 400 years ago. Whoever started it, the process is time-consuming. Farm families would slaughter a hog in January when the meat could stay cold naturally. Then the hams and bacon and other parts were rubbed down with salt and hung in a smokehouse for a year.
In the old days, they would trim the apple trees from the apple orchard. A lot of farmers would say they wanted apple wood. Some of them would use hickory. Some of them would use oak, sometimes a mixture of wood, to color up the hams. This also kept the insects out of the building.
Bob Feltz, owner of the Feltz Packing Company in Southampton County, says the pattern didn't change until the Great Depression, when so many people left the farm for work in the city. Come the holidays, they'd go back to their parents and grandparents and ask for a ham for their holiday dinner. With demand growing, commercial processors like himself found a new market.
The way we cure these hams now, with controlled temperature, where every day is the same temperature, same humidity, we're able to duplicate what they used to do in 9 to 12 months. We're doing it in 90 to 120 days.
Felt says every farm family used to have their own secret recipe, using combinations of white sugar, brown sugar, molasses, and pepper to create their special flavors. While all hams have to be cooked, only a country ham is cured and can last a while without refrigeration. Just like in the old days.
Just the dry salt, and then Mother Nature giving it some time to age and cure. That's the biggest thing, is the aging and perfecting of a ham is just giving it time.
Feltz and his crew reproduce the old techniques in his modern plant. They salt, wash, hang, cool, dry, heat, and smoke the hams, then ship them out to grocery stores, farmers markets, and restaurant chains. Or they're sold to individual customers who remember the taste of a country ham from childhood. And, of course, these days you can get a Feltz country ham off the Internet as well. Feltz says there aren't too many meat processors making country hams anymore. Changing diets and busy lifestyles have cut their customer base dramatically. But country ham still has its fans.
We still see a lot of country ham that is eaten in restaurants. Most of the time at home, you've had the bacon, you had the sausage. So you get to a restaurant, you get a choice, they'll eat country ham.
And that holds out hope for his family business, which has been around since the late 1930s and is still going strong. In Ivor, Virginia, I'm Norm Hyde, reporting for the Virginia Farm Bureau.